Mavs fans around the world. Today is a day for rejoicement. Today is a day for celebration. Today is a day for happiness. Today is a day for the future. Today is the day that Donnie Nelson has been relieved of his position of GM of the Dallas Mavericks. Can I get a witness? So many of us have petitioned for this, loosely speaking, not really petitioned. Well, maybe some people have actually signed petitions. Some people have wanted this for so long, me being one of them. So many Mavs fans have wanted this, and I was not expecting this to happen. Not only this offseason, but this early. If you're not aware, if you're a Mavs fan, you're aware. Maybe some people are watching this who aren't Mavs fans. There was an article that came out 2 days ago. I believe it was 2 days ago, about the Mavs front office. There being, you know, a lot of dysfunction in the front office. I won't necessarily get into that because I may either make a separate video about it or you can just go check it out for yourself. But in the midst of that, a lot of people was like, okay, who's going to be the scapegoat for this? Who's gone? Who's going to be leaving? And it turns out it was Donnie Nelson. And apparently said they mutually parted ways. I'm not exactly sure what that means. I mean, I'm sure what it means, but I'm not sure why they mutually parted ways. I'm pretty sure we'll know more over time. I'm pretty sure they said there's supposed to be a press conference tomorrow about his exit. I guess they want to do it the right way since he's been with the team 24 years. Understood. Show him some respect. But this is huge for the Dallas Mavericks, bro. This is huge for the first step in the future. This is huge for the new process. They said they were getting aggressive. That's what they're doing. That's what it looks like they're doing. And it started with this, and a lot of people weren't expecting this. Me, myself, being one of the main ones. Just yesterday, I was in a locker room for my Mavs Outsiders podcast with me and my co-host Bibbs. That episode is out now if you like to listen to it. And one of the guests was in the locker room saying, talking about Donnie and him leaving and possible replacements. And I was adamant in the fact that I don't see them, let alone parting ways with Donnie, but not this offseason. And little to my knowledge, it happened the very next day. So what does this mean for the Dallas Mavericks? It means the Dallas Mavericks are aware of their position. Luka Doncic is a top seven player in the league, in my opinion, one of the rising stars in the league. This will be his league one day. We're in a great position. We took the Los Angeles Clippers, to seven games on the back of Luka Doncic alone. It got a lot of mainstream media attention, which means a lot of people saw it, which means a lot of people were talking about what the Mavs need to do, what they aren't doing right, what they don't have, what they need. And it put a lot of pressure on the front office, along with that article from The Athletic that Tim Cato wrote. And I feel like this has a lot to do with that, especially the mainstream media part, that the attention we've been receiving. I love it, man. I love it. It means they're headed in the right direction. They talked about being aggressive this offseason. They're doing it. Apparently, there's a team that has been put together to look for the next GM of the Dallas Mavericks. That's not my job, so I don't have any ideas. I don't know guys that are out there. A lot of people have mentioned Masai Ujiri's name. I don't see him leaving Toronto, but if he did, I would gladly welcome him. I will drive him. I will fly to Canada. Fly him to Texas with my check, myself. Book his hotel and everything. Like, whatever he needs, I'll do it. And if you listen to this, I'm dead serious. I will do it. I'll do it. This is the first big step in the Dallas Mavericks process this offseason. Now that this is out the way, a lot of people can chill back because a lot of Mavs fans have been up in arms recently on Twitter and probably other social media platforms as well about what's going on with the Mavs. So hopefully this will put a lot of people at ease. They can chill, we can rest knowing that, hey, the Mavs are serious about making moves. Next step is finding a GM to fill his role. Hopefully this person is good for the job. And then after that, we can focus on the offseason ahead. And that's not until August when free agency starts. I don't see us making moves before then as far as like trades and stuff. I'll make a separate video about moves I would like the Mavs to do this offseason. Probably not specific moves, but ideas, the type of moves I'd like them to make, as opposed to, hey, go get this player, you know? So I'll be putting that video out. It won't be today, it won't be tomorrow, but it'll be soon. But this is a big day, man. Whether you're rejoicing or whether you're upset that they got rid of Donnie, whether you agree with the situation or not, one thing we can all agree on is the Mavs are making moves and the Mavs look to be serious about doing something this offseason. So for all Mavs updates, bro, I will be making these videos. For all Mavs updates, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Ding the notification bell so you know when these videos come out. I'm not as fast as Shams and Woj. Don't expect that out of me. I have a 9-to-5. So if it don't come out the day of, don't kill me. But you get the note, you ring the notification bell, you'll know when it does come out. Leave a like on the video, leave a comment in the comment section. It helps the video a lot. Let me know what you think about Donnie's firing. Y'all aren't fucking owners, but still, let me know who you have in mind for the position of GM. What are your expectations for the offseason? All things Mavs, leave it in the comments. If you made it to the end of this video, put hashtag MFFL in the comments, and that's how I know y'all got to the end. Till the next one, I appreciate y'all for watching. Peace.